All right. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to IAC's Passport Program. And tonight we are visiting the community Tikkun Liao Shavuot. And we have Rabbi Gil Shredro of Congregation Agudas Akim with us. And again, the Passport Program is a way that we get to visit different congregations in our community to get a deeper understanding of who our neighbors are. And IAC's mission is to cultivate peace and respect through interfaith dialogue, service, and celebration. So we are so glad you've joined us this evening. And Rabbi Gail, thank you for letting us visit with you this evening at this community-wide learning evening. So if you can just go ahead and share a little bit, well, share about this event and why you do it.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, first of all, Simone, thank you so much for inviting me and Congregation Agudas Achim and really this community-wide event to be featured as part of IACT's Passport Program. And thank you all of you for being here tonight, whether it's a relatively early hour, which I guess I shouldn't assume everyone's in Austin or not, wherever you are. So tonight begins the holiday of Shavuot, and it is the holiday on which the Jewish people celebrate receiving the Torah at Mount Sinai. I'll get into that in a little bit. And the program that we're going to be experiencing is, as Simone said, the Tikkun Liao Shavuot, which literally means a repairing of the evening of Shavuot. So on Shavuot, the Israelites were to receive the Torah at Mount Sinai in the desert, in the wilderness, after having been wandering for a bit, having been freed from slavery in Egypt. And they were told to prepare themselves and to stay up all night in anticipation. I don't know if any of you remember the Disneyland commercial from, like, I think it was the 90s, might have been the late 80s. There were these British children and they had the cutest accents. And it's like, I can't sleep. I'm so excited. Because like we're going to Disneyland the next day. They couldn't sleep. And it's for me, that's always what I think about with Shavuot, this idea that the Israelites were supposed to be so excited that they couldn't go to sleep. But as they often do in the Torah or the Hebrew Bible, as you might be more familiar with the term, they messed up and they fell asleep. And so tikkun means a repairing, and Liel is night, so repairing of the night of Shavuot. So as we anticipate celebrating this holiday, celebrating receiving the Torah, and again, it's not just this idea of remembering that the Torah was received, but we're supposed to see ourselves as though we too are experiencing divine revelation this evening and receiving the Torah in this moment. And so we have a chance then, as you know, we often try to do things better than we did previously and to stay up in anticipation of receiving the Torah. And there's a really beautiful commentary and teaching and understanding of this idea that every Jewish person that ever was or ever would be, that their souls and their spirits were present at Mount Sinai, which is part of this idea then that when we read the Ten Commandments as part of our Shavuot service tomorrow morning, which if anybody's interested in coming to, we can share that link for you too. But this idea that we stand as though we are receiving the Torah in that moment as well. So as part of Tikkun Liao Shavuot, then different communities have different ways of, experiencing this, I guess, at Agudas, and in our community, it's a pretty big deal. And so we join together with the other Jewish communities in Austin, with the other synagogues, and there will be, usually there's a theme for the evening, and there will be multiple tracks that people can participate in throughout the evening. So the theme for tonight is Into the Unknown, which feels very fitting right in this moment. And so then we'll have teachers, let's say, from different congregations, both clergy as well as lay leaders and sometimes there have been Jewish faculty members from UT or other universities in town. And sometimes it is very specifically Jewish related. And sometimes it's more on the themes of the evening or in a larger sense. So we've had everything from like a movement session where we were exploring the Torah through dance, and we've done an ethics session. And one year our synagogue had adopted a new prayer book. And so we had a session where we were exploring it and learning that together. And later this evening, I'm privileged to be on a panel with Simone as well as Muna Husaini. And we're going to be part of the track that's seeking one another. And it's an interfaith dialogue as we explore what the role of prayer is and faith as we enter into the unknown. And one of the, I guess, one of the reasons that I really love Tikkun Le'ol Shavuot, I think, is from my own experience when I was in college of having stayed up all night. I'm from California. I went to the University of California at Santa Barbara, and our Hillel, which was the college Jewish student center on campus. Just before dawn, we walked to the beach, and at like 6 in the morning in the freezing water, like all went in and recited what would be the closest thing to a creed if Judaism were to have one. It's a little debatable from a scholarly perspective, but it translates as, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one." And we read the Torah on the beach, and it was just really amazing. And there's something I think really powerful about being together in a community and having this shared experience. And especially for anybody who's ever pulled an all-nighter, there's a little bit of that, I don't know, a specific type of energy that comes at 3 in the morning when you haven't been getting enough sleep. And so when we're in person, certainly our social hall has lots of tasty treats and lots of coffee. People have been known to take a cat nap perhaps before coming together. But that's sort of like the big picture, I guess. And I don't know if there are questions as well. And certainly I can share a bit about Agudas Achim a little too. We've been hosting the community-wide night of learning for at least 12 years now, sort of in this iteration of things. And it's really lovely. I'd say, you know, over the course of the evening in previous years, at least over 250 people or so would come and go to different sessions. And it was just a really nice way of being together. And it's our second year online now. So, which is also has its own, I think, unique opportunities. So, Simone, I don't know if there were specific questions.
Tell us a little bit more too about Congregation Agudas Achim.
Yeah, absolutely. And I realize I'm like, oh, right, what are some of the other things we do to celebrate Shavuot? It's not just this evening. This is like the big lead up, right? So Congregation Agudas Achim is conservative congregation in Austin. Conservative as the idea of conserving the tradition. We're egalitarian, which means that men and women are able to participate fully and equally in our services. We welcome anybody to join us at any time. And we also have a particular understanding of revelation, of the giving of the Torah. Different denominations, as within other religions too, interpret the particular tenets of the religion, I think, in their own slight variations of ways. And so in the conservative movement, there's the idea that that we conserve tradition as well as being able to change and adapt to the present world that we live in, right? So the Torah might not have specifically spoken about the ways in which women might serve in leadership capacities. And, you know, here we are today in the 21st century. So, and what does it mean to stick with what were the specific realities that existed that led for laws and rules to be created in a particular way? Do those still apply today? Not just, you know, oh, well, yes, of course, people are equal. And how do we interpret the laws so that we can hold true to what their original meanings were and be able to adapt? So there's a lot of thought that goes into that as well. I'm privileged to serve with Rabbi Neil Blumhoff, a dear friend and colleague who many of you may know from his time with IACT as well. So I'm the associate rabbi. Rabbi Blumhoff is our senior rabbi. I've been here for almost 7 years, I guess. Which is, yeah, it's a lot. Time flies when you're having fun. And we, as part of our traditional services, so we have Friday evening and Saturday morning services for Shabbat, the Sabbath. Jews typically, traditionally will pray 3 times a day. And so we have these daily services. We gather as a community twice a day, in the morning and in the evening at 6, and then depending on times, daylight savings and things, sometimes it's considered the afternoon service and sometimes it's considered the evening service, just depending on where the sun in the sky is. One of the other things, just really thinking about the holiday of Shavuot, the thing is that we celebrate receiving the Torah. So like the big moment is we read the Ten Commandments in the morning. We also read from the book of Ruth, which folks might be familiar with. And this idea that Ruth is known for her loyalty, and she declares to her mother-in-law, Naomi, among other things, where you go, I will go, your people will be my people, your God will be my God. And this is really a true, seen as a real testament of faith. And as in some ways the first example of somebody choosing to be Jewish. And so this idea that the Israelites, when they were receiving the Torah, didn't fully understand all of it, right? Today, most of us would not sign a contract without understanding all the things in it. And the Israelites are said to have said, Na'ase v'nishma, we will do, and then we'll understand. Then we'll figure things out as we go, which is a bit foreign perhaps for the ways in which we live today. And that Ruth really exhibits and exemplifies what it means to just come at something with a full heart and a full sense of faith, of just jumping right in and saying, it's all going to work out, but I'm all in. And that the only way to really do this is to be all in. So that's along with the fact that as part of the story, there's the barley harvest, which is also Shavuot, is a harvest holiday. So Judaism has 3 festivals. Chagim, one in the fall, Sukkot, or Festival of Booths, as some folks might be familiar with. So that's the fall harvest holiday. We have Pesach or Passover, which is the spring harvest, spring festival. And then 7 weeks later, so Shavuot literally means weeks, like W-E-E-K-S. And we count the days from Pesach, from Passover to Shavuot, and it's 49 days. So it's a week of weeks. And so the holidays literally means weeks. And it's this idea of counting the omer, which is it's like a unit of measurement of barley. And so that's the harvest that's happening also in the story of Ruth, which ties in as well.
So Rabbi, tell me, why is it from 8 to 2?
Tonight?
Yes.
So we've discovered that online, people's attention spans are just a different length than they are when we're all together in person. And so our live offerings are started this evening at 8 o'clock as evening was coming in and the holiday was starting. And we're going till 2 in this way. And then our congregation is partnering with a collection of conservative congregations in around the country and around the world. We'll be hosting those online learning opportunities all night. Also, actually, Rabbi Blumhoff and I are teaching something at 11:30 soon after our panel. If one wanted to stay up all night before joining in for our services at 9:30 in the morning, one could participate that way. When we're in person, we've been known to go all, you know, till 6 in the morning or so. Yeah.
Wow, that's fascinating. Any questions, Rabbi Gail? James, yeah.
I was going to say, you mentioned conservative. Not everybody is familiar with conservative, reform, non-denominational even. And
all the things.
Yeah.
Is there a question or just to explain a bit about the different denominations?
Yeah, I know the difference. I'm not sure of everybody else.
No, I appreciate that.
Yeah.
So there are several different denominations within Judaism. I think there's often a conception or a perception that it's one, you know, one Jewish people, but yes, and. And so some of the other denominations include reform, which is the idea of reforming the tradition. There are two reform congregations in Austin, which folks might be familiar with. There's also orthodoxy. Again, this idea that there's one way of being orthodox, it's a bit of a misnomer. And then also reconstructionist, and there's some renewal also on all of these different denominations. The difference primarily is on practice. The Judaism focuses a lot on how we do things. There is the idea of believing in one God and this one particular God. And beyond that, there's not really a whole lot of emphasis on belief. It's much more on our actions, on this doing, which is why Na'aseh V'Nishma, this idea of we will do and then we will understand on this holiday is highlighted so much. So things like keeping kosher or observing Shabbat or the ways in which we engage in business ethics or to what extent we look after the vulnerable in our community or strive to save a life, all of these sorts of things, that those are really, those are important obviously to everybody in their own ways. But there's nuances of the interpretation certainly for particularly the commandments that are involved. There's different categories of mitzvot, of commandments, positive, negatives, right? Like the you shalls and the you shall nots, but also mitzvot, sacred obligations that are ben adam le chavero, between a person and their fellows, and ben adam le makom, between a person and God. And most folks, I think, are relatively on the same page about, you know, how we treat one another. And then there's a lot of interpretation of, well, what is God really asking of me? What does it really mean for, what does it mean to keep the Shabbat? What does it mean for me to observe the Sabbath? What is the role of keeping kosher, for example? And things like that. It's, you know, we're all figuring things out. Thanks, James. I'm mindful of the time. I realize right. There's one other celebration piece that I don't know how I forgot to talk about, probably because we're not in person, which is food. And so the food for Shavuot is a bit different than a lot of our other holidays. A lot of Jewish holidays are known for including lots of meat, but Shavuot is known as a dairy holiday. Specifically, the main idea, there's two thoughts that are most popular. One is that the land of Israel is described as a land overflowing with milk and honey. And so milk, right, dairy. And then the other is the idea is on Shavuot, we celebrate receiving the Torah, but all of the nuances of keeping kosher, which is in a lot of ways very focused on the elements related to meat, were not fully understood yet. And so there's an understanding that the Israelites, until they figured it out, were vegetarian. And so we're eating dairy. So lots of things like blintzes you might have heard of, which are like crepes with cheese and cheesecake. We had homemade pizza in my house this evening, which was really yummy. That would be the sort of standard fare that you would find at a Shavuot celebration. So.
Awesome. Joanna, did you have a question?
No, thank you.
Okay. So I put the link on the in the chat. So what we're going to do, I know this was a pretty quick one, but we're going to go to the next session, which will be at 10, but we need to get in there 10 minutes before.
And I realized also, I'm going to just put my email address in the chat. And so if anybody does have questions that they weren't able to ask now, I won't get to it till later in the week. I won't be on my email for the holiday for Monday and Tuesday, but happy to connect if something comes up that you're not able to ask as part of the larger session.
So if y'all can click on the link that we put in the chat, and that way there is the session, the interfaith session that we're going to do at 10 o'clock. And I mean, you're welcome to go to all the different sessions that they have, you know, it's going on till 2 a.m. in the morning.
Yeah. So, Simone, I'm able to include the chat directly for the link for the session that we're going to be in.
Okay, great.
But right. Simone, if you want to see all of the things, because you're welcome to go to any or all of them, then the link that Simone included will give you that too.
Awesome. All right. Well, thank you all so much. This was like the shortest pre-meeting that we've ever had. So
first time for everything.
Thank you, yeah. Rabbi Gail. It was wonderful.
Thank you.
Thanks,
Rabbi,
for having me. It was fun.
And it was the first time we ever had something at 9:30 at night.
Well,
right?
Well, there you go. That's why it was shorter also. It was harder to do a bit earlier. There was a lot of preparations getting ready for the holiday. So appreciate your flexibility, everybody.
Well, this works are good because our session is at 10. So yes. I hope y'all can join us. Okay. And click on the link. All right.
Bye now.
Thank you all so much. Thank you, Thanks. Rabbi. See you shortly.
Absolutely. See you Bye-bye. Soon.